The citizens of today are enjoying the convenience of digital service delivery, which many private sector companies have put at their fingertips. So, most citizens now would want and expect the same level of service from government agencies that they have received from online retailers. And government agencies which can create seamless digital experiences that can satisfy the expectation of citizens and be responsive to their citizens' needs will earn the trust with their citizens. But while many city governments are becoming more digital, there is still a gap between what citizens want and what they currently get. The question is, how do we make cities smarter and make informed decisions leveraging technology? The fact is, the wisdom of the crowd is everywhere. We just have to know how to find it. It is much more possible now to gather information about people's day-to-day activities and use this behavioral data to figure out what do people really want through the millions of apps and Internet of Things sensors available. Essentially, a smart city is about taking that wisdom that's already there and accelerate it using technology and behavioral economics to design infrastructure improvements that will make citizens' lives easier and safer and more prosperous. Working with AWS, Deloitte has developed City Synergy, which is a suite of smart city solutions built on AWS Cloud. In the next 20 minutes, we will take you through what is City Synergy and how can this integrated solution help decision makers control, monitor real-time KPIs and SLAs, and make data-driven decisions to create a smarter city.
Thank you, Tiong Chu. Hi, everyone. This is Suresh here from Deloitte Consulting. So I'm going to share a little bit in terms of how Deloitte sees the smart city to be. Like, we see it as one that enhances the quality of life, minimizing the hassle of city life, creating a business-friendly environment that results in effectively attracting the best talents and investments to drive the economy. But most smart city implementation efforts actually do not optimize the use of available resources. And why is that? Now, at Deloitte, we have found three key reasons for this. Firstly, organizations put in an immense amount of effort to build data warehouses to create insights to improve their services, but then they forget about all their bite-sized insights that could immediately be available as new services to citizens, right? So that's reason number one. Now, we look at reason number two. Governments continue to ensure that the entire data collection and storing process are secure and private. Now, but this means that you are only ensuring that the data is stored in a secure cloud location, but not at the source where the data is being collected. Now, take, for instance, an IoT camera at a traffic junction, right? It could have the last 1 minute recording erased by a hacker at the source. You don't need it to go you don't need the data to go all the way back to the cloud, right? Lastly, we have the age-old problem of trying to reinvent everything, but with different solutions or in an unharmonized fashion. Now, this often results in useful data being available to one public service agency, right? But not necessarily to the other agency, which may have a different data standard. Now, to deal with this triple data constraints, Deloitte has created City Synergy built on AWS Cloud. It's an integrated city OS with specific set of functionalities that's related to the core functions of any city. It consists of a command center for city operators, an executive dashboard for city decision makers, and mobile applications for citizens. Now, let's take a glimpse into how City Synergy was used during the global pandemic.
Deloitte developed the COVID War Room concept in order to support cities facing these challenging times. The COVID War Room is anchored in City Synergy, Deloitte's city operating system, from where all the city operations are controlled.
In the specific case of Qashqaish, the COVID War Room was quickly implemented to guarantee decision makers the control over the municipality's pandemic situation and the access to real-time information necessary to take urgent responses.
We wanted to be an example in the management of COVID-19, and above all, we needed to guarantee health, safety, efficiency, and speed and results in responding to citizens and tourists. We wanted to have an integrated view of what was happening, and this war room gives us all of that.
For example, if Jason is traveling and has to do a COVID-19 test, he just calls the hotline provided by the municipality to book it.
Hi, can I book a COVID test, please?
The call center operator takes the call at the COVID-19 war room, and she uses City Synergy to check real-time availability of all the testing facilities in Qashqai. The testing center receives Jason's appointment in real time, and Jason immediately receives the confirmed schedule of his appointment.
This specific solution for pandemic times allows real-time monitoring and reporting of COVID-19 occurrences in the city, provides an integrated vision of the situation of the pandemic since it centralizes the requests from citizens or other occurrences, allows test scheduling and the disclosure of the results, and facilitates the monetization of the available resources, which creates synergies and avoids overcrowding or scarcity scenarios.
When the citizen, Jason, goes to the testing center, his sample is collected for analysis. COVID War Room consolidates and centralizes information throughout the process. As soon as the testing center analyzes the sample, the COVID War Room cases report is immediately updated and Jason is informed of his test results.
It was actually very easy. I just called the number that is advertised everywhere. They scheduled my test 2 days later, which was awesome. After 24 hours, I was supposed to get the results, but actually, I got the results on the same day. You know, we see what's going on in the world, and we are very lucky that we are in Qashqai and we live here.
Our goal is to guarantee and assure the safety of our population and to give confidence to face this pandemic, facilitating and regulating the return of economic activities. The COVID War Room was absolutely critical in achieving this goal.
You saw how City Synergy was used during the global pandemic. Now let's see how the components of this solution looks like. Now City Synergy Command, as you see there, is the core of the City OS, unifying the events, incidents, and requests across the city with dynamic asset management. Now, right next to it, you also have City Synergy Intelligence, which includes cognitive algorithms for machine learning and artificial intelligence to create projections that support planning for growth and scale. And alongside that, you also have City Synergy Insights. It provides visual reporting information about the service and operations that's not only relevant for decision makers, but also for citizens. And to make this entire system more ecosystem friendly, we have City Synergy Integrate, right? So this extends the entire command center through the integration of modules, such as vertical service domains, through the likes of APIs, and we can also do it through IoT, legacy systems, etc. Now, that's not all, right? So we also allow citizen and stakeholder contextualized communication and social login. Lastly, and probably the most important of it all, we've got a secure protective layer called City Synergy Protect that meets pretty much all of the GDPR compliance standards. Now, with a clear picture of the components, let me hand this over to Varun from our cloud engineering practice, who's going to share with you all about the AWS services that actually powers what is underneath the hood.
Thank you, Suresh, for giving me such a good opportunity to explain the technical aspect of the Smart City project. But before going to in depth in the Smart City project, let me introduce myself. So my name is Varun Kumar, and I'm a senior cloud engineer in Deloitte Consulting. And I have a diversified experience in AWS cloud more than 8 years. And I'm an APN ambassador too. I'm running my own YouTube channel, as well as I'm delivering many technical AWS lecture in the AWS tech community. So that's all about me. So let's go with the project. So City Synergy has a various AWS services that provide a smart city. But before I go inside that technical aspect, let me give a high level data flow designing in front of you, which you can able to see in this slide. So the first thing is that to getting the massive data in the real time, and that data will be coming from the real-time sensors. So once you have the data, you have to ingest in the data injection technology. And from there, you can able to run the analytics in a real-time analytics or inside the data lake. And once your data and all those things inside the data lake, you can move to the batch analysis as well as the interactive dashboard where all the operational guy can be visualize the outputs. Let's talk about the City Synergy a little more. So City Synergy is a Deloitte integrated smart city and smart place operating system, which has incorporated various AWS services to power a smart city. It also includes other vendors too, for the different services. But here we're going to talk about the AWS service related regarding this smart city, right? So think of a smart city as an operational brain that supports a city command center and a nerve system that provides the sensing to the brain through integration and security and connecting all stakeholders. So this empowers city managers and the stakeholders with the capability to coordinate and manage the response effort, access to predictive impacts, as well as monitor KPI and SLA for service provider to make the data-driven decision. So this is the summary of the smart city, how it works at the back end. So let's talk about the smart city technical example. So I'm taking an example of traffic. So let's suppose in Singapore, we have, you just stopped at a bus stop and you open your application in your mobile and able to find it out when the next bus will be coming to your stop and what is the, where exactly the bus is located right now. So all those things happen with this data sensors. So all the sensor which is available inside the transportation, like all the data which is reside inside the buses or cars, sending the data to somewhere, and from that cloud or from that data centers, the API will work, and you are getting the information in your application, like phone application. So this is the example, and let me go through this slide where you can able to see the technical aspect of the AWS cloud. So this particular slide is divided into the two part. One is the real-time streaming sensors, where the sensor is already put it. So you can see the vehicles over there, and all the vehicles have the sensors, the traffic lights, the video cameras, the Wi-Fi signals. So all these devices are sending the massive amount of data inside the AWS IoT. And IoT is known as the Internet of Things, right? So you guys must aware about this IoT, which is a very famous word right now, right, in 2021. So this IoT are sending the data to the data ingestion as well as the Amazon Kinesis. So if I can go through the Amazon Kinesis or IoT, IoT solution has a full device management and security capability, which can allow connected device to interact with the cloud application. And Kinesis as well as the Kinesis analysis will provide process and run real-time analytics to the data ingested through a AWS IoT. And these services also can deliver data efficiently to other services such as Amazon S3 or Amazon DynamoDB. And in the second part of this slides, you can see the data lake. And this data lake will be built up with a couple of services in AWS. The Amazon S3 is used for the storage and formerly known as a simple storage service. And then we are utilizing the AWS Lambda. AWS Lambda is a compute serverless engine that eliminates to need a write up a complex code. In all, then a city can begin analyzing data and making real-time decision without employing a large contingent of the developers, right? So we can reduce the developer and all those things should be happening in the serverlessly. There is no use of the servers, no complex operational things in the technical aspect, right? And for the DynamoDB is the NoSQL database, which is also a serverless technology provided by the Amazon Web Server. And all the real-time data can be stored inside the DynamoDB with help of the API gateway or with help of the Lambda functions, right? So here you can see the IAM. So IAM is one of the key most component in AWS, which is formerly known as the Identity Access and Management. So this will provide you the authorization, and if you are an authentic user, then what work you are able to authorize. So these are the things provided by the IAM. And for the Cognito is the fully managed service from the identity access and management, so that user can able to log in towards the portal, and they can able to use the smart city things, such as logging to the Facebook or such as logging to the Google account. Similarly, the user will log into the smart city portal also. So to make the city more secure in the technical prospect, we also have a key management service. Like AWS have a key management service that allow a server side or the client side encryption for data stored in S3 or data in transit. So all the data is encrypted, so everything is very secure. So in the next part, if we are going for the real-time analytics, we can see the Amazon EMR. EMR is known as the Elastic MapReduce, which is used for the big data analytics. So if I can explain the EMR, it is in a highly distributed computing framework, can provide the capability of analyzing large scale of data, like traffic management data sets in a real time, as well as through the batch processing, okay? And here you can see one term known as machine learning. So machine learning, formerly known as the SageMaker services in AWS. So SageMaker provide the capability to perform predictive analytics, and it can easily create a machine learning model without learning any complex machine learning algorithm or other technologies. So this machine learning is very helpful and formerly known as SageMaker. And if we are going to the last part of this particular slide, which is interactive querying and visualizing. So you can see there is a two part. One is a data Amazon Redshift as well as Amazon QuickSight. So Amazon Redshift is formerly utilized for a large amount of data where we can utilize the data warehouse. So Amazon Redshift is fast, fully managed data warehouse that makes this simple and cost effective to store the structured data. And this allow users to query petabyte of structured data using the sophisticated query optimization and massively parallel query execution. As QuickSight, we are using QuickSight for visualization of the data, and it offers a cloud-powered service that make it easy to build visualization, perform ad hoc analysis, and quickly gain business insight, and it enables City Synergy to build a real-time dashboard for all connected on the street assets. So all the operational guy which is sitting inside the room, they can visualize all the data from the help of QuickSight. So guys, this is the technical overview of the City Synergy project inside the AWS. Thank you. Thank you all.
We have seen how the pandemic has made digital an imperative to the delivery of public services, and many large-scale digital innovations are being rolled out right now at an unprecedented speed, laying the foundation for future digital government. At Deloitte, we are constantly researching about the complex issues facing the public sector and developing relevant, timely, sustainable solutions for our clients. City Synergy provides a holistic view into the heart of a city. And together with MSense, Deloitte's AI-powered knowledge platform, city decision makers now have real-time insights on systemic trends, ecosystems, and customers at their fingertips, and are able to make timely and informed decisions on their strategy and operations. We hope that you have a better understanding of the solution, and please feel free to reach out to us anytime to start a conversation. Thank you.